Hey, 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 welcome to the DVP channel, and today I do have a final game for you, which is the Magnolia versus Barrow Mangus. And the Barrow Mangus will actually go first in this game, riding to the Great One that does Soul Charge on right, and he does go for the Brother Soul, which does Soul Charge too, pushing him to already 4 souls in just turn 1. Man, this deck can be quite good if you do hit the 15 souls in the first right. Right now, the Magnolia player actually does go for the Zoga chain, right, allowing him to actually Soul Blast 1, and drawing 2 cards, and he must discard an order here, which he does so, or not, he must discard 2 cards. And he does begin the aggression here with the 8k and swinging the Vanguard here, which does guard to a no pass there. So very heads up move, because a critical trigger there would have made the game very, very stressful for him, as he go to the Great 2 here, which doesn't have any skill yet, and he does have the other Brother Soul here, pushing him to already 8 souls if I'm not mistaken, no, 7 souls. And he doesn't do anything else as he hit the side, which is guarded by the Magnolia player to allow him to actually have the aggression continuing on. And now he does go for this discard, riding into the Great 2 Zoga chain, right? Allowing him to pick up the order which he did discard in the previous turn. And this order can be used in this turn if he does Swan too, which he does. Allowing him to actually superior call the Great 1 Panda, if I'm not mistaken. Allowing him to plus 5k. And it will be a very beastly booster, as he does call the draw trigger as well as a Mantis here to actually have a full field aggression against the DI player. And now this is a very good move, because against DI, most of their hand is actually mainly used for the soul charging and not too much of guarding, as the Magnolia player does manage to push the Barrow Mangus player here to actually 4 damage already before he reaches a Great 3 turn. And what will the turn actually change, you know? How will this turn unfold? As he does go for the Barrow Mangus here with discarding the Great 2, and because of the Great 2 ability, he's able to Soul Charge 1 from hand, drawing 1 and Soul Charging 1 more card, accelerating himself to 10 souls already, as he does call the Great 3 here, which will Soul Charge 2. He does call the Great 2 girl, as well as this Great 1 Garner guy, which does Soul Charge 1 upon calling, as he does go for the corner plus 2 from the Great 3 guy, allowing him to have the front row plus 5k. Now he's gonna swing at the rear here. And he actually does guard it, because he does want the aggression to continue. And does counter charge due to the Great 2 girl. And the rear guard will keep hitting the rear guard here. He does go for the Barrow Mega skill, which does quite a lot. But he does have only 10 souls, which does give him plus 10k and 1 crit and 1 draw. Twin drive into double blank. And the Magnolia player does eat it quite healthily, as he does have 0 damage to begin with. And now he does go for his own Great 3 right here into the Magnolia. And this should be more or less game, as he doesn't have any hand size for the Dark Six player, and the Magnolia player will actually start the aggression with the full field right here, with the Mantis giving plus 5k power to the back row, pushing to 5 already here. And Magnolia will swing unboosted, because the back row will be an attacker. No guard will be announced here, no critical trigger, but it should be the last damage to push. Just power to the back row once again, and no heal trigger to save the game, and this is 1-0. Now the DI player, or rather the Dark Six player, will actually go first in this game now, riding to the Great 1, which allows him to Soul Charge 1 upon riding. And that should be all for his turn, as he does pass it to the Magnolia player. The Magnolia player will actually discard the draw trigger, which is the perfect discard fodder, as he does ride from the, does draw from the starter, and now using Soul Blast 1. To draw 2 additional cards. And looks like he doesn't have an order, as he does discard 2 cards here, and without any other commitments, he does swing the Vanguard here. And no guard here. Dredging into order, man, that's some, you know, unlucky stuff, as he does finally just see the order there, which could have saved him 1 card at least. But the Dark Six player, will actually go to the Great 2 here, calling the Great 1 to Soul Charge 1, pushing to 4 souls, and he does call this card down, which allows the Soul Charge 2, similar to an Elmburn Master, or rather just a Rapid Soul Charger, as he does aggro with it. A damage trigger found for the Magnolia player, so very fortunate, but he does guard for the no pass here, I believe, and no trigger there, so it's back to the Magnolia player turn. As he discard the order here for the right deck requirement, to right to the Great 2, which does pick up a normal order back to hand, so a very effective use of the right deck discarding mechanic. And now he does call the Great 2 Maiden Girl to actually call the Mantis, which does have a very good on-place ability, giving a unit plus 5k upon calling. Now he does call the Great 2 Tiger here, and looks like he'll be continuing his aggression from the previous game, making sure the DI player doesn't have much room to breathe, which is the correct play. And now the Magnolia player will swing the left column first. No, he does reconsider and does decide to swing the Vanguard here into a blank, which a critical trigger here will be very nice for him. The left column will be hitting with a 23k column, 15k guard. A no guard once again by the Darkseid's player. And he finally guard with the over trigger. Man, so the over trigger is already gone for the Darkseid's player as he does go for the grid 3 right here. Allowing him to use the proc the grid 2 skill here, will allow him to soul charge 1 from hand, drawing 1 card to soul charge 1 more card, pushing him to 9 souls already. And now that's called the grid 3. Allowing him to soul charge 2, pushing him to 11 souls. He does have another one, so does push him to 13 souls here. And only have one hand size to work with, and he does call the final card from the hand, and which is the Great Tugger. Now the Great Tree will go for the counter blast 2 here, which will be a plus 5k to the front row, a mini front trigger at that, and does decide to hit the side. And using the Great 2 Ghost Chase here to actually guard it, bouncing the Great 1 back to hand. And he does go into the soul to counter charge. And a very hiss up move actually there, because if he does let him hit, he's able to hit the 15 soul requirement, allowing to use the mega combo of the Mega Mangas. A no guard here, a huge trigger to be found here, which is very clutch in my opinion against the Magnolia player. And a double huge trigger, okay. I have no comments for that, but effectively making himself only 1 damage against the Rush player. So basically what Magnolia has done in the previous 2 turns has become gone to waste. And the Magnolia player will have to restart, and the Barrel Mangas actually already have 15 souls the next turn, which is pretty scary. And now he does go for his own Great Tree right here, pushing out the Mantis, going for another Grey on order play. He does call the Mantis once again, which does give the other Mantis plus 5k, so he's able to hit the Vanguard unboosted here. No guard from the Darkseid player, no trigger here, very fortunate for him. The Magnolia player will swing and he will need a miracle here, twin driving into a critical trigger at least, bumping to the Neo Nectar Great 2 card on the left column. And now using his skill to plus 5k to the back row panda. The back row panda does plus 5k when you do swing from the back row. If I feel a 10k guard, the Darkseid spear do eat the damage here. It looks like he does guard for the final attack, leaving him with no hand size, and he does need one card that can soul charge here, which he does have, allowing him to actually soul charge 2 here with the grid 2 core, pushing him to already 15 souls, allowing him to have the full barrel magnus effect, which does allow him to actually superior core 2 more cards from the soul for a multi-battle. And not just forgetting that it does plus 10k to that 2 units as well. So you know, it's a card that does quite a bit if you ask me, as we do fast forward here, as he does call the Great 3 and the Great 2, which does go to a Kanzen here because he's at 4 damage already. And a critical trigger will be dry check here, pumping to the left side, which will be at least 25k gun. It looks like the strategy does give up here, and this is game. Now we move on to game 3 here, and the Magnolia will go first. Hopefully have the advantage here, and the double heal from the previous game does put him in a spot. And now he just discard the Blitz Order here, which does fulfill the requirement of the Great 1. And the Barrel Magnus player will actually go for the Great 1 here to draw 1 first, then soul charging 1 due to on-right skill. And he does commit the Gunner already, soul charging 1, pushing him to 3 souls, and he'll be swing with it boosted. A no guard will be caught here, just checking into a grid 3 there, no trigger from both sides. Looks like he'll be discarding the draw trigger here once again, and 2 draw triggers have already been out. He casts call the grid 2 Tiger, as well as the grid 1 Panda, as well as the Mantis here, to actually go for the aggression. But the Darkseid player do each to a damage trigger to stop the assault straight away. And finally, the last column does swing for a 5k guard, and looks like he does throw a 15k shoe against that. So we begin with Great 2 turn with only 1 damage, which is quite healthy against the Rush from the Magnolia player, as he does call another Great 2 here, which does soul charge 2, pushing him to already 6 souls, a very healthy gain. It looks like he'll be swinging the Great 2 at the side here, and the Vanguard will be swinging at the side once again. No guard from the Magnolia player, and just checking into us all the card. So not exactly a shield, but it's still a soul charge card, which does push him to his winning condition, as the Magnolia player will begin with only 1 regard on the field, and we shall see how will he be able to replenish the field, as he does call the Magnolia out, which can be bounced back from the Ghost Chase. It's probably why he actually called it out. Or not, usually you do want to keep it in your hand, but he does just check into a heal, which does prevent him from actually using the skill to give to the back row Great 1 attacker, which he did leave behind. So very unfortunate of the heal trigger there. Sometimes heal trigger does come at the wrong time there, but the Dark Sage player do have a draw trigger to make his life easier, as the turn do pass to him as he does discard for the right deck. Riding to the Barrel Magus here, Barrel Magnus, I don't know why I keep saying Barrel Magus, maybe because he does feel like a mage. And now he's able to do the Great 2 skill, allowing to draw 1, Soul Charge from hand, and Soul Charge 1 more. And now does call the Great 3 rare here, which does Soul Charge 2 more. And does have another one, Lusahi does always have these guys in hand. Very strong player. And now does call the Great 2 girl once again, and does go for this order, which allows him to actually Soul Charge 1. And for every 5 souls, he's able to give 10k power to 1 unit, as he does give to the Great 2 girl. He'll be swinging the Great 3 first for 5k guard, which is a no guard from the opponent. And he does eat to a damage trigger here, which does use the Ghost Chase here to actually bounce up another player, even though it's just 10k guard. Sometimes Ghost Chase does make you guard awkwardly and more than you need to, but it is what it is, as he does go for the Barrel Magnus play here. Lion, which he does already have 15 souls, so he's able to call the 2 Great 2 girls there, just checking into a double blank, but that's 1 negate there. And a critical damage will be done, but he does eat to a second damage trigger here, pushing to 33k, and the both girls on the side is not able to swing. He's able to strike to his Magnolia here for a personal right, which he did bounce off in the previous turn, as he does call down 2 Red Guards here, and that will be most likely it. So very unfortunate that he doesn't have much units to call, and the Kazan will be forced out here to prevent a double crit situation. Just checking into a crit at least, now using the skill to actually plus 5k to the Mantis there, making it a 15k guy at least. He does eat the damage here, but he does eat into over trigger there, so making the Vanguard plus 1 million power. So the side is only able to hit the side now, and that will be the turn over. But do note that the over trigger is also a huge trigger there, so it's very handy for the Barrel Magnus player. Now the Barrel Magnus actually does go for his personal right here, plusing 10k to the front row, and the front row will be effectively having steroids. But he does eat into a huge trigger here for the Magnolia player, so it's very unfortunate for him, and the side will not be able to hit, and he doesn't bother to swing the side because Barrel Magnus will actually use a skill to actually suck in all the red guards from the field, and he does call 2 more red guards there, which is the Great 2 girl and Barrel Magnus itself. And the over trigger will be used to here to guard, so allowing him to have a no pass, as his over trigger has already been reviewed. But that's your check into a draw trigger here, passing to the power to the girl. And the Barrel Magnus, it will actually be swinging for 33k himself. 25k guard, no, actually just 15k guard from both sides. And this is an effective guarding turn. But Magnolia doesn't have much hand to work with, and after all, the Barrel Magnus player will only have 3 damage, so there's no lethal in sight. But let's go for the order here, calling the over trigger here, which does have a, you know, have a potential chance that he can actually use the Ghost Chase to bounce it back to hand. And looks like the opponent will actually go for a no pass here to prevent a double critical situation. And looks like a double crit does indeed happen, so a very heads up play by the Dark Sage player here that she got. And now the over trigger will actually swing with 2 triggers on it, so a total of 30k guard if I'm not mistaken, 25k guard sorry, and it'll be all thrown by the Dark Sage player. Now he does have, he does personal right once again, giving front row 10k buff, and this should be it in my opinion, as he does call more regards to the field, and this regard will be swinging for 23k by itself already, and this column will be quite big, 38k and 30k shield will be thrown by the Magnolia player. But looks like the Barrel Magnus player here does use his skill to actually suck in everything to call 2 more units, and does call the 2 great ones, which does hit for 38k by themselves. So it's too ridiculous. And looks like he will be hitting for 30k guard and 30k guard, and this should be game. Pushing to 5 and finally 6 damage. Now thank you for watching till the end, and do consider subscribing, dropping a like and a comment if you do enjoy the content.